Yes, Suha Lee is an amazing man that can stand up for himself. But can we appreciate how the other secretary felt like there was something off from what he saw in the hotel hall? So he decided to follow them and stay. He saw the signs and stayed, and dang it, I have mad respect for that. Before we get started, I just want to remind our viewers that if you like seeing more Yaoi content and would like to support this channel, please don't forget to smash that like button. Also, if you haven't done so, please subscribe to this channel and hit that notification bell. Feel free to message me in my Twitter or Instagram at ZEALED FUJOSHI, which I'll be using to interact with viewers about more Yaoi content. If that's something that interests you, feel free to follow me at ZEALED FUJOSHI. Finally, this video will contain explicit content and a lot of manhwa spoilers. With that in mind, please proceed with caution. You have been warned. Now, without further ado, let's jump into chapter 66 of My Suha. This is going to be a very short podcast because there wasn't really a lot going on in this chapter that I wanted to comment on. I am just so proud of Suha for standing up for himself. We were all upset with the previous chapter when he kissed Doyuk in front of Jiwoon, but you know, now that we see the next chapter, we kind of see like he has this improvised, not planned plan. Is one way of saying it. It's well improvised. I do have to say though that this chapter is one of the most disgusting, stomach churning and irritating episode I would review in the history of this show. And I'm so angry at Doyuk, and I wish that Suha should have bitten off his eggplant off instead. But I appreciate his effort, and I understand why he could not wait any longer, because if he gave one of his famous blows to Doyuk and actually bit his eggplant off, you know, he could have picked up, my gosh, a plethora of diseases. I mean, Doyuk, he got so many. So boy, no way would you want that thing in your mouth. No one would want to get down on that. So I understand why Suha didn't wait until he gives his famous blows, you know. We'll settle for a tongue or a lip, whatever it is. I mean, but then again, I also just hope that he bit off his whole tongue off so he would shut the hell up. But then again, imagine the germs inside that mouth since it's been in so many asses. You know, you, who would want to be in that position? God, you don't know where that mouth has been. I mean, that, yeah, you don't know where that mouth has been. How many asses that mouth has been on. My God, the germs that's on that mouth. Probably more dirty than a toilet. Anyway. Man, Suha is so cute in this chapter, but you know, it's kind of sad what's going on with him in this chapter, but how the author drew him, he's so, even when he's in so much stress, he's so beautiful. You know, no wonder so many people want him. I feel bad for him, but you know, he deserves so much more recognition and appreciation. And I think the next chapter is gonna be a little bit of a disappointment, but the chapters after next chapter, we'll be all good. Like I told the rest of this of my viewers, just wait until December is over. January, hopefully, is a better week. I hope you enjoyed today's episode. I hope everyone is going to have a happy holiday. Please don't forget to follow my social media to be teased about some of the boys' love that I'm interested in. Feel free to leave me a message and converse with me. I'd love to hear back from you. Also, don't forget to support the author. All the manual details can be found in the description below. Again, thank you so much and hope to see you next time.